There's been multiple cardiovascular outcome trials since like 2013. There's been around 11, and a few more are coming out during this meeting. And they've mostly have shown really exciting data showing that those new diabetes type 2 drugs, they provide cardiovascular benefit. And but we didn't really know how this relationship is affected when patients are treated with these new diabetes drugs and with insulin, which is a combination that we see very frequently in clinic. So that was the aim of our study, is to look at the cardiovascular outcomes in patients who use these drugs in those cardiovascular trials, and they were on insulin. Lucky for us, there was a good amount of patients in those trials where they were at baseline, they were on insulin, so we were able to look at those numbers. Now this was a meta-analysis, so the trials are known, like I said, there are 11, so we looked them up on PubMed, Google Scholar, but they're very well-known trials. Six of them actually had shown cardiovascular benefit. They were mostly the SGLT2 inhibitors and the GLP-1 agonist drugs. But we looked at all 11. Now, not all 11 had the data that we needed to do our analysis. So we ended up taking out four. One was DPP-4, one was, two were DPP-4, one SGLT and one GLP-1. So that left us with seven trials. And we also did a sensitivity analysis. For that one, we took out the DPP-4 trials, which there was one left because we had already taken out two. So we used the STATA program, and then when we looked at the results of those, we had multiple analyses. We looked at first just using the drugs versus placebo without any insulin, so patients who had not been in any insulin. That showed us that the drugs, the group that used the drugs, they had less cardiovascular outcomes, which is kind of what we already knew going into this. Then we looked at patients who were on the drug with insulin versus just drug. Now, the group of patients who were using drug with insulin did have more cardiovascular events. So that was the main thing that we were looking at. What we did see from our results is that patients who were using those drugs, even though they had more cardiovascular outcomes when they were using insulin, there was still benefit. So giving those drugs with insulin, it still provided cardiovascular benefit. So implication-wise, what we're saying is that maybe those drugs should be started a bit earlier than when we usually do use them, because we do know they provide cardiovascular benefit. And also, even when they're used with insulin, I mean, anyways, if patient is needing insulin and the new drugs, they usually have worse control of their diabetes, so it kind of puts them at higher risk for cardiovascular disease. That was our thought maybe behind our results. But it's still a combination, even when the drugs are used with insulin, there is still benefit.